Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. This episode is the part 2 video in a series on security in BLE. I recommend you to go to the video description to find the link to the part 1 video and watch that video before watching this video. So in this episode, we will cover security modes, levels and do an overview of different security keys. Let's get right into the concepts as we have covered the fundamentals in the last video. There are two security modes in Bluetooth Low Energy, Security Mode 1 and Security Mode 2. Security Mode 1 is concerned with encryption, whereas Security Mode 2 is concerned with data signing. Now let's look at the different levels of each mode and what it means. Under Security Mode 1, there are 4 levels. Level 1, No Security, which means no authentication and no encryption. Level 2, Unauthenticated Pairing with Encryption. Level 3, Authenticated Pairing with Encryption. Level 4, Authenticated LE Secure Connections Pairing with Encryption. Under Security Mode 2, there are 2 levels. Level 1, Unauthenticated Pairing with Data Signing. Level 2, Authenticated Pairing with Data Signing. Now that the modes and the levels are clear, let's do an overview of different security keys used in BLE. 1. Temporary key. The TK gets generated each time the pairing process occurs. The TK is used in legacy connections only. 2. Short-term key. This key is generated from the TK exchanged between the devices. The short-term key or STK gets generated each time the pairing process occurs and is used to encrypt the data throughout the current connection. The STK is used in legacy connections only. 3. Long-term key, also known as LTK. This key gets generated and stored during phase 3 of the security process in legacy connections and during phase 2 in LE secure connections. It gets stored on each of the two devices that are bonded and used in subsequent connections between the two devices. 4. Connection signature resolving key, also known as CSRK. It is used to sign data and verify the signature attached to the data at the other end. This key is stored on each of the two bounded devices. 5. Identity resolving key, also known as IRK. This key is used to resolve random private addresses. This key is unique per device, so the master's IRK will get stored on the slave side and the slave's IRK will be stored on the master side. We have now concluded the two-part series on security in BLE. That is all folks, if you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.